Okay, this will be our supply drop. Very nice. Very, 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 very nice indeed. We have 172 intel, so we can certainly reveal that. What have we got going on here then? Advents seem to have taken note of our own soldiers' advances and strive not to be outdone. Alien scientists make great strides, instantly adding one block to the meter. Aliens improve their threat response and guarantee reinforcement. We want to stop them all if we can. And we got our supplies there, but we'll go make contact here first, I think. Everyone's back now. I think. Just nap more still to go. I'd say we could assign new research, but do we? It's literally just that, isn't it? Right, our scientists shall be idle. Right, now, in fact, why? Why would we not tell them just to do that? I don't even know what we really get out of it, because I can't be bothered to read anything, but why would we not do that? So, we'll finish making contact here. There we go! Now, everyone's back now. Everyone's back and ready. But I still feel as though... Ooh, my goodness. All primary weapons gain an additional upgrade slot. Some stuff that's happening here is amazing. We have no money, because we need to go and get those supplies first. So we'll go get those supplies. And then we will go and do this Codex mission. With everyone fit for battle. Hopefully we're going to get some kind of idea as to what enemies we can face, and then we can decide whether to take another heavy or an offensive specialist. But still, let's get these supplies first of all. There's some. Oh, this is not really what I wanted to have happen right now, but let's go do it. Andromedon, Muton, Gatekeeper, Elite Shield Bearer. My goodness me, we just got to neutralize a target. It's an important mission. We can't ignore these missions. So we have to go do them. But I really want to get that codexing done. But it's not as though we're in any rush right now. Look at the Avatar Project. We got it right down. So, I saw Gatekeeper on there. I saw Andromedon on there. That means we're taking two heavies. Oh, man. Oh, man. Oh, man. Oh, man. Oh, man. I'm liking this. I'm going to give him a scope. I'm going to take away his war suit. I'm going to just give him the Warden armor, which is the best armor that he can have, isn't it? Because then he can carry a plated vest and he can just be very tanky. Okay. We're going to take him out. And we're going to put him in. And I'm going to give him... Oh, weapon upgrades, apparently. So you can have a superior repeater, critical hit chance. Extended magazine, probably very useful considering he's a heavy. And then he will have the war suit, and he will carry the shredder. Shredder was awesome. Or shredder storm cannon, I should say, was awesome. Okay, that's good. So he's ready, he's ready, he's ready, he's ready. But we all have weapon slots now, don't we? So let's make use of these weapon slots. A stock. I don't plan on her missing targets, so I'm not going to give her that. Let's see what Vogel has, because Vogel probably hasn't had anything yet, has he? No, indeed, he has not. So he can get a repeater. 15% chance to instantly kill, and he can get a stock. Why not? Why not, man? And that's all we got to give, guys. Okay, well, let's go and neutralize the target, shall we? This is the A-team right now, as I look at it. Let's see how good we can do. This, assuming no one gets injured, will be the team I send to the Codex coordinate mission. Or I'd send no Pablo, or Paolo, I should say, and I'd send Arena in his stead. But right now, this is promising. Swamp God. Capture or kill the enemy VIP. So this is the thing where, if we capture him, we get the intel. If we kill him, we only get the resources. Ideally, we want to capture him, but I'm not going to risk any lives to capture him. I think in the past we've just blown him up because he's been near aliens and it's been easy. In fact, the last time we did a mission of this variety was when we lost Sean and his son for that time. That was a horrible day, wasn't it? But it's fine now. It's fine now. I'm loving this FPS, by the way. Can I just say that much? It's real good. Loving how long it takes to load in. I'm loving a lot of things right now, but I'm loving looking at Sean and Tickle and Paolo and Klaus and Amanda and he's not in shot, but the other guy. Nat Moore. There we go. Okay, right. We ready for this? We ready for this? Okay, if we can start on a building, which I don't think we have done, but we do have a grappling hook, so that's not so bad now. Then I was going to say it would be in a great spot, but that is unimportant right now. Where are we headed? There's the VIP. Oh, he's a bit of a distance away, isn't he? What has gone on there? Jesus Christ! So we've got to capture him. Now, what I would do is take Amanda Hart and put her up here. But if we're only going to be going into this building anyway, not really much point in me doing that. So we'll just send everyone moving forward. We are concealed, so we can bear that in mind. Not necessarily have to worry too much right now about covering things. Although it's always a good habit just to keep. We know there's a gatekeeper here. That's why we've taken two guys such as we have. We can deal with gatekeepers. We dealt with gatekeepers really well last time. There's nothing to worry about here. And we can score critical hits with our grenades as well. How cool is that? Okay. Just getting people moving right now. We're concealed. We don't have to worry too much about getting flanked and things until next turn when we break concealment due to some massive idiot play by me. 12 turns. That's a pretty good amount of time, isn't it? I hear something. What do I hear? I don't know, but I think we're going to be better off going through the buildings. Wait, this is kind of further. No, it's not that further. It's not that far, is it? It's far when we have to fight it. But otherwise, it's okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get Gizmo to here. And then that's just going to give us information. I'm going to find out what we need to know. And there's still no one? Okay, then. If you say so, we'll get Tickle up top. Obviously, Amanda can follow him. I would say we'll go through the building, but I don't want to risk misclicking and breaking glass and losing concealment. Oh, it's a car showroom. Nice. Yeah, as I said, I don't want to risk losing concealment or anything via a misclick, which I think is understandable. So we'll get everyone else going round in the way that Gizmo's going, with the exception of these two that are going to go on the roof. Yeah, that's a good idea, I think. Long term, a good play. Sean Hudson to here. I need me some water, lads. Where's me water? I am parched. I've been playing this game for a while today. Okay, there's me liquids replenished. I'm loving this Shredder Storm Cannon. It's damn good. It's damn good. All right, Nat Moore to here. Okay, that has worked out. Well, I don't know if it's worked out or not yet. I'm just trying to say words that maybe make me sound analytic because analytic people are intelligent. So, her on the high ground, obviously. Tickle on the mid ground so he can still hit range up. And I expect to see enemies down here. Oh, look who it is! Look what it is! On the building, right where I want them. Not really where I want them at all. We're going to have a bit of a rejig of where all our guys are right now, aren't we? Sean Hudson can get to there. The two that can be ever vigilant, Nat Moore and Clout. Oh, and there's a thingy in there as well. Man, oh man, this is awkward. Right, Knockout can go to here. Gizmo can go up top because he can. Oh, that's going to break concealment. Can he not go this way? Okay, well, I guess he can stay on the ground then. Yeah, this is awkward now, as a matter of fact. This is not really how I'd envisaged anything going down. Getting that more over to here. Yeah, we're in a tight spot. It doesn't have to be a tight spot so long as everyone makes their shots. Because we've got three ugly things coming this way, and it's very likely that we lose concealment here, because they're very close to Sean Hudson. Although Sean could have a great time of reaping. That gatekeeper's still there. That's the big issue, isn't it? But I don't feel like we can delay any longer. So what we'll do is we'll maybe put her in a position like that. We will... yeah, we can't do anything really, can we? If we do this, are we going to take the floor out beneath our guy's feet? It looks like we are. So there we go. And we're back. Okay. Sorry about the technical issues there, my friends. It hasn't really compromised us too badly. We're still in this pretty dratted position. Now, I was talking about what are we going to do, because obviously the decision would be to grenade this group here. I'm going to take the floor out of these guys' feet, so I'm going to need to move these guys. Can I do so without breaking concealment? I can move Nat Moore without breaking concealment, apparently. And he can head to here. Oh! Hang on a minute! The radios are back up!
Eyes on the prize.
People have got voices again! Oh, that's awesome! Oh, I'm okay about that. Right, so Tick... Oh, no, we've got to move him, though, haven't we? We can move him to here.
Confirmed.
People have got voices! Yeah, man, that's awesome! You know what? If he even drops a grenade... If Tickle drops a grenade down there... Oh, Sean's not in cover then, is he? Right, let's put Paolo on Overwatch. We've got people with voices, guys. How cool is that? Yeah, if we do that grenade, Sean's out of cover, because it'll blow up his cover. But it seems like such a smart thing to do. Can we just maybe scooch the grenade this way a bit? Oh, we can. That's fine. Okay, yeah, we'll do it that way. And then Sean overwatches. Has everyone now got what they're doing? It's just these two to do something with. Okay, so she's going to kill zone this area. I thought we'd already asked her to do that, but that's fine. We've got voices! Yeah, man, that's awesome! Okay, so...
Bombs away!
Bombs away! Oh, it's glorious! Did we get a critical there? I think we did! Someone got a critical. I can see the numbers. Well,
we're visible here.
They're pretty dead, ain't they? Ain't they, Tickle? We're visible right here. Right, if they run towards us, we're getting Bladestorm actions going on, aren't we? I'm confident about this. Nice! Nice! Nice!
That's it! Bersaglio eliminato. Big deal.
Oh, it's good to hear you guys again. It's good to hear him again, isn't it? So obviously this pops itself back up. But oh, look, it's an alien. I can actually see... The game works, guys! How crazy is that? Right, now we have a kill zone here. Which apparently is not going to work for Amanda Hart. But that's a good... You know, it's an acceptable hit from Nat Moore. And she missed. I'm still not convinced about her. I've got to be honest. No, that is not good. Right, well, still, there's this to deal with. That was a good ambush, though, in all. Here we go with the shots. That's better. That armor, though, man. That's why we're taking two heavies on this mission, isn't it? We've got to have the heavies hitting it. Oh, and here we go. Here's the big injury for everyone. Luckily, we got Vogel. So this is going to knock a load off everyone, isn't it? Okay, no one panic. Obviously, Sean untouchable. Ugh. Bit horrible. Okay, well, did it only hit two guys? That's okay. Oh, there's another chap here. What's he going to do from this position? He can't target Tickle, can he? Ah, blimey. Okay, armor helping us out a bit there. Let's get the gatekeeper killed. Oh, and then we got this. Oh, he's got a blade storm. Nice. We've been silent for so long. It's so weird to hear people's voices again. Right, so there's some things that we gotta do. Right, don't worry about it, guys. We're gonna do a mass restoration this turn, I think. Well, look who's out of cover now. Alright, well, Kesima Boos are up to here. Everyone's injured, but that's why we got a big medic now. Hailer Bullets, 100% there, but he's probably going to be... He's 100% anyway, lovely. Okay, well, let's get rid of this armor, and let's get this guy killed. Nicely done! Nicely done. That knocks his shield out, that knocks his armor out. And now we can just shoot the guy. Nat Moore, would you like to just shoot the guy? You've got a double shot to do, haven't you? That's not Nat Moore. Where's Nat Moore? There he is. Okay, get him dead, Nat. Or do we just want to take the one shot there? We can get him dead. But he's still got three armor up. Let's think about this a little more carefully. 100% there to kill that thing, which is good. Because then that allows Sean and Paolo to be effective elsewhere. Nice! Nice! Okay, so Sean needs to get somewhere. Can he run and gun, Sean? He can run and gun. He can run and gun up to here. And then we'll see what he can do. He can run and gun further, actually. Do we want to get him to there? I'm not sure. I feel like here's safer. And it's not going to make much of a difference in terms of him killing stuff. 61% for the gatekeeper or 51% for that guy. Not going to kill either of them, though, is he? Vogel's going to do a mass heal, because I think we need it. 38% there. Is it safe to grenade it? No, Nat Moore's there, isn't he? Okay, we're just going to have to try and take a 38%. Or... Well, let's just get him into some cover first. And I realise what I've done there is maybe compromise his ability to shoot. No, we put him up to 39%. It's meant to be, guys. That is disappointing, but kind of expected. Yeah, right. Okay. Nat Moore's going to shoot it. Nat Moore's going to run to here. No, he's not. Nat Moore's going to run up here and then shoot it because he will probably be getting 100% if that's the case. Because of height advantage. Weapon rate. Everything's working here for him. 82%. This will be 97% still only. Well, let's take the 82 and let's kill it. Let's get it gone. Nice. And again, son. And again. What the F just happened there? Well, he killed it. Not sure why you're now on the floor. Okay, now you're back up there. It exploded and you fell down. I see. I see what happened there now. I see the issue. There's a guy down here that we can drop a grenade on, perhaps, isn't there? No, we can't drop a grenade on him. We can shoot him. Or we can shoot this guy even for 84%. That might give Sean the opportunity to kill him. If we make the hit. We do make the hits. Is it enough? We're going to find out with Sean Hudson very soon. Yeah. Not really sure what's happening with Nat Moore right now. 51% there to not make a kill is not great. We can't reap because we can't see anyone to reap. Might as well take the shot. What's the worst that could happen? Well, that could happen, and that's an amazing thing that could happen. Okay, let's get a restoration down on everyone. Because I feel like Nat Moore might be in an endless loop of falling to his almost death. So we'll get Klaus Vogel further forwards. And we'll get a restoration going. Everyone gets healed now. Okay, so he is down there then. I'm so... this game, man. Okay. Tickle gets a heal. This building's collapsing. We need to get people off it. Sean gets a heal. I feel like this is what we need to do if we're against gatekeepers. So I think what we've got is we've got a first four, and that's Amanda, Sean, Nat, and Tickle. And then we've got a sort of group of three of which we take two of, and that's going to be Klaus. This is going to hurt. That's going to be Klaus. That's going to be Paolo, and that's going to be Arena. And we take two of those three depending on what enemies are on the floor. Because if we're not against a gatekeeper, we might not even need to think about taking a medic or a second heavy, which means Arena definitely comes. Okay, that's that guy dead. That's what he gets for grenading us. Well, the building was going to collapse, wasn't it? Oh, God. Yeah, we've actually got a mission here. We're not just killing people. Amanda Hart. Oh, of course, she doesn't have much armor, does she, anymore? Because we're giving her a spider suit. Okay. Well, let's keep her going this way, then. We killed all the enemies, man, but we're all a bit injured now, which very much sucks indeed. But still, it ain't all bad, is it? Blimey, Paolo, you're still over here? I think we're good. I think we're pretty good right now. Gizmo on the other side, because he has his always-on Overwatchy thing that he does. Nice, and in fact, so does this chap, Nat. Fanuel Moore, who we can put here. I don't know what's going on with him right now. I think he's safe where he is. Okay, Tickle, let's get you further forward as well. We're going to have a turn of reloading if we can afford it. We've got six turns left, but we've killed the two big horrible enemies that were going to be on this mission. I think it's just going to be less bad ones now. Hey! Yeah, these are less bad ones. Love to reap with him. I think we'll do the sensible thing. Get us a kill, Sean. I don't even know what we're going to shoot here. You know what, man? Shoot at this one. Whichever one that is because of glitches. I don't know. It's weird. If this was a Total War game with this many glitches, I would be shredding it. I would be hating on Total War. But because it's XCOM, I don't know. It's okay. Because I'm weak-willed and love the game series so much that they can release a not completely complete game and I'll be happy with it. No idea who we were even shooting at there. I don't even think Sean knew. But that's okay. Right, Amanda Hart can't kill anyone. What Amanda Hart can do is... Where's our extraction point? It's there. Okay, well, what Amanda Hart can do then is run to here and maybe get a pistol shot off. Maybe not. She can. Beautiful. 37% is not thrilling, is it? I think we're going to need to use some grenades here. Can't use grenade there. Okay, Mabuse has already moved. This guy hasn't already moved. Let's get him to some cover and get him shooting. Or get him grenading. Grenading wouldn't be a bad idea at all. I feel like if we can kill that shield bearer, our next turn's going to be a hell of a lot easier than if we can't kill that shield bearer. Shredding armor. Nat Moore. Oh, man. Can you slash something, please? 85%. It will make him untouchable. Let's do it. Kill the guy. Nice. Okay, so this guy's untouchable. Super. Okay, that was the nastiest thing I'd say. Paolo. Let's send him round here, actually. Let's get some flanking action going. I know we're leaving loot behind, but we got more pressing issues right now. So where is that VIP then? Is she on? Oh, she's there. I see. And what made that is more what I want to know. What caused all that blood? Let's go find out with Amanda Hart. I'm not sure. Do all you like, man. The guy's untouchable. Overwatching. And overwatching. Well, guess who doesn't trigger overwatches? It just happens to be my main man. Nat Moore. 55% there, 25% for the elite officer. Why is that so low? I don't know, but let's use these barricades to our advantage. Oh yeah, this guy does trigger overwatches. My bad. Not too bad though, 5 damage we can deal with. Can he hit both of them actually? He can. That's going to be glorious. Oh, what a thing that is. Oh my lord, did he kill that guy? And just get a big hit on that officer? Amazing stuff. Right, Tickle, let's just get you in here. Man, that is a good weapon, that. We're going to be using that a lot. Right, Sean Hudson, you can take our VIP. Actually, no, we'll have the medic do it. Seeing as everything that he's useful for is done with his robot anyway. He can use his hands for something this time. Subdue her! Man, that was an overreaction, one would think. Sean, do you want to go slash that guy and get it done? Nicely done. Yep, that is enough. Good-e drum drops. Remember the days when he was a sniper. Okay, Gravedigger can head... Oh, extraction point's only there, so she can... that car's going to explode, potentially. So she can head here. And then she can get some kind of overwatch next turn, which would be good for her. Wild Child Nat Moore can head out. Take a free reload and then get himself on overwatch. Beautiful. That's indeed what I like to see. Good. Okay, so in about 30 minutes, the game might register that, you know, we've got another turn to do and that we've taken the VIP. So then we can get on with it. Oh, man, that was a big stretch that I just had there that you didn't need to know about. But now you do. How do you feel? This is kind of unacceptable. I have to be honest. But for some reason, I'm accepting it. What does that say about me? Okay. Overwatch. I'm being cocky like this because I do not expect a thing to live next turn. Overwatch and he'll be blade storming. Gravedigger on, well, might as well kill zone this area. Knockout. I'm just going to have him running forward so he doesn't miss the extraction next turn. We've got time, but I want to get everyone out at the same period. So Sean's going to be all over with his blade. And we'll pick up this unit. Hello, my dear. Let's go. And then we'll head our merry way on out. This was a good mission, all in all. Gatekeeper did what gatekeepers do, but we had a good counter to it, so I think we can be pretty happy with our day's work. Now, I want to see these enemies go down, because I want to see Nat Moore and Sean Hudson just have a field day. This is where they're dropping down. We've got two guys with Bladestorm and shotguns. Let's see anything try and live. Hey, boys. How's it going? Oh, hi. Right, let's get this done. Welcome to the knife party. Oh, beautiful. And everyone's on Overwatch as well, aren't they? Wait, are we doing more blade storms? What is going on now? That guy's dead. Good job, Tickle. They all died. Amazing. That was brilliant. Welcome to the knife party, guys. Right, let's get out of here. That's how you deal with reinforcements. I liked that very much. That was damn glorious. I love the feature of how we see our guys here on, like, most wanted posters. It is good, isn't it? Right. That was great, though. I enjoyed seeing that a lot. How do you deal with reinforcements. You get all your guys that are good at close combat, and you stand them right on the entrance point for them. And before you know it, they've swung their sword so many times, it's just pieces of Advent on the floor. So yeah, that was really good. And we will be getting on out of here. Okay, so is everyone going to be injured or are they not? I'm not sure. I think everyone's going to be out for a couple of days, which is going to delay us, but that might not necessarily be a bad thing. It's not going to be a good thing, but it's not as though we're really under any pressure with time right now. So, yeah. Anyway, let's get Gizmo out with our VIP. And we got... Well, we had guys on the radio for a little while as well, which was awesome. Anyway. That's the ticket. And then just Wild Child Natmore on his way. And we are good. That is a glorious pile of Advent that we're leaving behind, isn't it? Let's get out of here. Yeah, buddy! Okay, so we do have 5 wounds to deal with, but that was awesome. That was really, really, really good. Wild Child deals the most. Wakesa and Wild Child are our MVPs on that one. Although everyone's the MVP. And our successful shot percentage was really low. It didn't feel low. It didn't feel like we missed any shots that, like, you would expect to hit. Like, you know what I mean? Oh, didn't we miss an 80%? Or was that mission previously? I played this too much, I'm forgetting stuff. But it felt like our successful shot percentage was a lot higher than that. But oh well. That was a good job, everyone. We did well there. And now we're back home. Very successful indeed. So we get intel, we get a couple of supplies. About, what was it, like 200 or something? 219, I think, if my memory serves. And 111 or 112 supplies. Lightly wounded, lightly gravely. Still, it was pretty good. And there's our VIP. 111 intel and 209 supplies. My guess was not so bad. Good job. Good job. Right, let's have a look at the numbers here. How long are our chaps out for? 2, 6, 9 at most with Amanda Hart. That's fine. That we can deal with. Well, that was very, very, very good. I'm going to end it here for today, my friends. Thank you so, so much for watching. I'll see you later. Bye!